taking his car and assuming he gives a fuck on, nigga.
Guys, listen, I'm sorry. I realize that I there's some really colorful language in that video, obviously. But I wanted to make sure that I shared it with you. I know some people are freaking out. Oh, you're a Christian. You shouldn't be sharing stuff like that. Listen, no doubt the language was horrendous, but you do have to put what was happening in context. I mean, obviously, testosterone was a rolling as this a hero, in my opinion, was preventing a carjacking from happening. So there's a couple of takeaways that I have in this video. First off, obviously, you see a black man with a gun defending his neighbor, who happens to be Asian, from being carjacked by another black man. One thing that's so obvious in this video is it's happening in broad daylight. This is California. It's happening in broad daylight. This is happening in blue cities across the country. Not only is crime becoming more rampant, but these criminals are becoming more emboldened simply because you got these soft on crime DAs that are in these blue cities and these blue states across the country. Another takeaway, there are more blacks out there that are willing to do good than blacks that are willing to do bad. Now, I have to be careful with this because sometimes as we report the news, even though black on black crime is prolific, sadly, it is prolific, that doesn't mean that the vast majority of blacks in America are good, decent, hardworking people that are just trying to get by like every other average middle-class American. All right, so that's the vast majority of black people in the community. I was convicted one time by a guy they called in at the then Larry Elder show and said, Carl, you're giving me all these stats about black-on-black crime. It's not that I necessarily disagree with it, but you don't talk about the good stuff that blacks are doing. And I'm like, man, you know what? All right, it's an effective point. He's absolutely right. Here's a case where a young black man is doing the right thing, standing up for his neighbor in his community, on his street, on his block. And I want you guys to understand that that is the case in the hood. Growing up in the hood, there's always a small percentage of people. Obviously, when I was younger, you roam the streets a little bit. You live in the hood, you know what's going on. And it seems like that the vast majority of people that I hung around with were, you know, decent people, but there were plenty of thugs as well. So it can skew the numbers. But the truth of the matter is the vast majority of people surrounding me were just good, decent people. I remember my neighbors to the right, to the left, the vast majority of people on my street, just good, hardworking Americans, of all stripes. So very important. Second thing, it's obvious. Again, another obvious point. A good guy with a gun was stopping a bad guy that, thank God, didn't have a gun. And this is very important. What the left always does, or what these blue cities, these mayors, and even the governor, Gavin Newsom, who's stringently opposed to the Second Amendment, what they don't realize is that good guys with guns will always do the right thing, or more times than not, do the right thing with a gun. This is a situation where a guy's, property, I don't know if the guy was still in the car, hanging onto the car. I couldn't see the Asian guy in the video, right? But a good guy with a gun, stop this thug with the gun. And also, if I could just go back to the first point, they're both black. They're both black. Now, I know he's using the N-word and stuff. Listen, guys, don't get caught up on that. It's a horrible situation to be in. You'd probably be using colorful language if you were in that situation as well. I hate hearing the N-word. I hate even hearing the F word, but in situations like this, stuff is going to fly. But this is proof that black good people don't like the black thugs in their neighborhood too. So just something to consider. Now, think about how emboldened criminals must be. This guy didn't run away. As a matter of fact, he didn't run away with a gun pointed towards him. He didn't appear to be scared. Even when the dude popped the cap up in the air, the dude was just like, just walking. Now, I don't know if he was walking away. Maybe, you know, we can't see his facial expressions. Maybe he was like, I don't want to make the wrong move or this dude will shoot me. But it almost appeared to me, looking at his body language, and I'm no expert in body language, but looking at his body language, I'm sitting there thinking, this fool isn't running. He's not doing any of that stuff. In his mind, he's probably thinking, man, if this fool didn't have a gun, I'd go at him. And that's how emboldened the criminals feel in these blue cities and in these blue states. So keep that in mind. The only thing that deterred this guy was force, force, force. Using force to kick this guy off your street. Now, here's the fourth thing. And I know a lot of you guys are thinking this. Okay, why didn't he call the cops? Why didn't he call the cops? He just let this guy get away, and this guy is going to end up carjacking again. All right, guys, this is the problem with soft on crime DAs. And I'm not saying you're right. I think I would have called the cops, but he's in California. So would the cops have come and arrested him instead of the criminal, or would the criminal have been arrested, released the same day, come back to that guy's house and done a drive-by? We don't know. And the reason why I'm calling this guy a hero is because that criminal could still come back to get him. But listen, this in my mind, again, this guy is a hero, a good guy stopping a bad guy by using a gun, happened to be a black guy stopping another black guy. And it happened to be a black guy that was protecting an Asian man. Why? I doubt because he was Asian. Notice one thing he said in that video. You're trying to bully an old man, an old man. This was a young black man, the guy that had the gun, that had respect for his elders. Something that we don't see, not just in the black community as much as we used to see, but in all communities anymore. It's a sad thing, but I think this video. Just so many points to take away from this video. So I hope you enjoyed it. Guys, please be sure to subscribe to my podcast, thecarljacksonshow.com, salempodcastnetwork.com, and wherever you find podcasts, and find me on social media, The Carl Jackson Show. Until next time, don't grow weary doing good. God bless you.